Hello everyone, welcome to our video series of MCQ practice question, and this installment we're going to talk about biochemistry. And if you're preparing for ITJAM, GATB, CSIR, NET or GATE, then this kind of sessions would be really helpful for you. Now let me tell you, we are going to practice 10 questions in 20 minutes, so stay tuned till the end. Now in this pandemic time, you know how hard it is to prepare and how hard it is to get out of your home and go to a offline tuition center. Moreover, it's not safe in this pandemic time, so you have to study from home and study safe. And in that journey, Unacademy might help you. Especially this announcement is for you guys who are preparing for MSc level entrance examination, because for all MSc entrance examination there is going to be a combined batch which would be dedicated to practice MCQ questions. And this question is in your mind, that where to practice question from, that would help me in this preparation journey. How do you understand, I mean, your preparation status, where do you stand, right? So these kind of sessions would be really helpful for you. But before that, let me tell you, there is going to be a price hike from today. So if you are able to take subscription within 9 hours, you can get to the old pricing, and otherwise you have to opt for the new pricing, which is slightly higher. But anyway, enroll right now and it would be beneficial for you. Okay, question number one. If Mr. Ali's HbA1c level is 8%, then he is suffering from hemoglobinopathy, diabetes, osteoporosis or rickets. So let me tell you, he is actually suffering from diabetes, and glycosylated hemoglobin is found in diabetes. If you want to learn more about HbA1c test, then you can click on I button. Okay, all the given enzymes are involved in glycolysis pathway. Which one of the following enzyme is not under allosteric regulatory control? So you need to understand what are the regulatory steps in glycolysis and which enzyme is not regulated via allosteric control, and this would be enolase. The phenylalanine metabolism is blocked in disease phenylketonuria. Which of the following product is formed during the normal metabolism of phenylalanine by phenylalanine hydroxylase? So generally, phenylalanine gets converted to a compound with the help of the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. So if you remember the structure of phenylalanine, if I just draw the side chain, so it would look like this, right? So phenylalanine, if it is getting hydroxylated, it would form nothing but tyrosine, right? And it is hydroxylated by phenylalanine hydroxylase. So this enzyme is crucial. So tyrosine would be the correct option. If you want to learn more, you know where to look for. Okay. Now, question number four says degradation of ketogenic amino acid results in a 2-carbon fragment. So imagine that 2-carbon compound, which may be formed into a ketone body, or it can also be diverted to a fatty acid biosynthesis process, or it can also be oxidized to carbon dioxide and water via which biological process? And the correct option would be TCA cycle. And the compound that we are talking about is acetyl CoA, which can be utilized for fatty acid oxidation or fatty acid biosynthesis, ketone body generation, or even TCA cycle, right? So this is the correct option. Question number five says, when substrate concentration is 10 times of Km, the velocity of the enzyme catalyzed reaction would be about. So coming back to our Michaelis-Menten equation, V0 equal to Vmax into substrate concentration, then Km plus S. So here we would have Vmax into, let's say, into substrate concentration is 10 times Km, right? 10 Km divided by 11 Km, right? So obviously 10 by 11 Vmax, which would be somewhere around 0.9 into Vmax, right? So this would be the correct option. Analysis of a sample of DNA found 20% bases were adenine. What percentage of bases are pyrimidines? So you know what are pyrimidines, what are purines, right? So if you have 20% of adenine, you would definitely have 20% of thymine, right? So okay, and rest 60% would be equally distributed, 30-30% for your guanosine and cytosine. So you have to count the total percentage of the pyrimidines, that would be thymine and cytosine, that would be 50%. Okay, which of the following is not true? This is a linguistic question, so you have to read it carefully. Hemoglobin is a tetramer composed of two alpha and two beta subunits, while myoglobin is a monomer. Myoglobin binds to oxygen more tightly than hemoglobin. This difference in binding energy makes myoglobin an oxygen storage protein, while hemoglobin is an oxygen carrier. Oxygen binds to both hemoglobin and myoglobin in a cooperative fashion. And D says protein part of the hemoglobin and myoglobin is encoded by different genes. So if you have read it properly and you have guessed the correct answer, this would be C. Because both of them, oxygen does not bind to both hemoglobin and myoglobin in a cooperative fashion. And if you want to learn more about hemoglobin and myoglobin, the difference between them, the video is in the I button. Okay, question number 8 says, this compound lipid molecule is exclusively found in mitochondrial membrane and usually have 4 hydrophobic tail. And this lipid is globoside, ganglioside, cardiolipin or sphingomyelin. So let me tell you, this is unique and this would be cardiolipin. And this was asked in several examinations in several years. Okay, question number 10. Oh, we are at not question number 9. Okay, so question number 9 says, the chitinous exoskeleton of arthropod is formed of polymerization of which monomer? Keratin sulfate and chondroitin sulfate, N-acetyl glucosamine, D-glucosamine, lipoglycans. So let me tell you, it is chitin that they are talking about. So chitin is made up of N-acetyl glucosamine. So this is the correct option. Last question is for you. This kind of questions you would be tackling in many examinations. So I'll put a video solution for this last question for you guys and how to solve these kind of question. That there is an easy method. So this says the net charge of the amino acid at pH 2.5 and at pH 7 is dash and dash. So consider this as a NAT question in IIT exam. So you can answer this question in the comment section. And I hope you like this video. So if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.